Good evening. Well, I hope everybody absolutely was enthralled with that spectacular tango dancing and musical performance. Our Argentinian colleagues, you know, had promised us in Malaysia that we would be blown away by the performance, and we certainly were. So I want to thank all of them for arranging this. Well, we've had a wonderful day, the first day of the Global Competitiveness Summit, and I want to, on behalf of the GFCC, welcome everyone for our gala dinner hosted by our Argentinian colleagues and friends. And tonight's a very special, exciting night because we have the third recipient of the GFCC Global Competitiveness Award. So it's my great pleasure and honor on behalf of the board of the GFCC and all our members to really recognize the excellence of leadership and impact in advancing competitiveness in nations with the 2018 Global Competitiveness Award, which this year will be bestowed upon Mr. Santiago Murtaugh, the founder and president of Alexancia Competitive and the chief executive officer of Culligan Water Argentina. So let me just share with you a little bit about the history of the award. Clearly, the Global Competitiveness Award's intention is to recognize individuals who are exemplars of vision coupled to action, individuals who bring together coalitions of people, they leverage new ideas, tools, and models, they champion new policies, get new legislation in place, and ignite others to join together in innovative activities to promote the economic growth, industrial and business development, and advance prosperity of their citizens. And such leaders really inspire us, and they offer not only to serve as role models for the next generation of men and women who will lead their countries, businesses, and societies, but to really be those who galvanize the very important steps we must take together to build the future of our nations in a time of great global transition and disruption. Many of you were with us in the GFCC in 2016 in London, where we launched the Global Competitiveness Award, and that award was bestowed upon His Excellency Amir al-Dabah, a global philanthropy and business leader and government transformer during his tenure as the governor of the Saudi Arabian Government Investment Authority. He launched the Saudi National Competitiveness Center and the 10 by 10 initiative. And we heard, of course, today how that work continues to be launched to bring the kingdom into the forefront of competitiveness nations. Last year in Kuala Lumpur, the GFCC award was bestowed upon His Excellency Professor Zakri Ahmed Hamad, truly a global scientific leader involved in the design and implementation of the UN Sustainable Development Goals and a true advocate and leader of sustainability in Malaysia and co-founder and co-chairman of the Malaysian High Technology Industry Group. Now this year, coming to Argentina, to convene the 2018 Global Innovation Summit and our meetings, we were very honored and blessed to be working closely with Santiago Murtaugh to make this happen. In fact, at dinner, we were remembering that it was 2011 when we first started working together when the GFCC met in Porto Alegre, and you had the vision to move forward to bring Argentina into this important network. So I want to say a few things about Santiago, which will take just a few minutes, but it's important for all of us to hear about his accomplishment. Santiago is the kind of person who has a characteristic that stands at the forefront of what the competitiveness agenda and movement's all about, because most of all, he is a builder. He's an architect of the future and a designer an implementer of, again, new ideas and models to advance the agenda and potential here in his nation of Argentina. Santiago is, of course, the president of three foundations, and he has put together the umbrella of the newly created Excelencia Competes. And now we see three important foundations coming together to share their assets, their resources, and their agenda to move the country's competitiveness agenda forward. Fundesi, the Business Foundation for Quality and Excellence, FINESI, the National Quality Award Foundation, and IPACE, the Argentine Professional Institute for Quality and Excellence. So now there's a new ecosystem of partners and assets to continue this journey of development and innovation and business competitiveness across the country. I want to share with you one example of EXC's innovative models for competitiveness that, again, is something that Santiago has played a strong leadership role in, and that is the Peers Board of Directors Program, which brings together small groups of small and medium-sized enterprise owners for cross-learning together. At each meeting, a host company presents its performance of issues to the group, which then in turn gives input on addressing problems and challenges, and importantly, offering solutions. A little bit what we did in the GFCC annual meeting yesterday, Chad. Then an action plan is developed and implemented, and so the partners are developing new skills in strategic planning, financial management, the new important and tangible soft skills, and again, networking with peer-to-peer from each other. And the Peers Board of Directors program, we're very proud, is highlighted in the 2018 GFCC Best Practices Report in Competitiveness Strategy. So these efforts championed by Santiago are really at a very important, critical juncture in the history of Argentina as it moves into the next phase of its economic development and transformations. Now, in addition to his national service and commitments, Santiago has led the Culligan Argentina business with tremendous results, and he's built upon his career in the financial industry, investment community, the CEO of startups, and bringing all of this insight into the work of this competitiveness agenda here in Argentina. So relative to the GFCC agenda on the future of production and consumption, I just want to mention that as president of Culligan Water Argentina, Santiago is not just passionate about sustainability, both from an environmental and business issue, but he is walking the talk. From his leadership at Culligan, he's been particularly focused on water and its link to food and energy value chains, where some of the most critical sustainability challenges lie. And under his leadership, the business and the sustainability agenda has really advanced, so much so that Culligan Argentina was awarded the Global Balance Scorecard Hall of Fame in 2010, which recognizes well-designed strategy and sustained excellence in execution, and Culligan was awarded the National Quality Award of the Argentine Republic in 2012. So I think we all know this saying in reality, and it applies to many, many people in this room, that it's often the people who are the busiest that get asked to do more things. And so Santiago continues to be in many leadership positions beyond his leadership of Excelencia and Culligan. He's the president of the Argentine Chamber for Bottled Water, the Center for Innovation and Strategy for Latin America at the IAE Business School. He's a member of the board of directors of the Lear Foundation, very important organization devoted to reading and literacy among Argentine's children and young people. Last year, this organization touched millions with the National Reading Marathon, more than 100,000 participants in projects, distributing 65,000 new books and more. So Santiago, with the 2018 Global Competitiveness Award, the GFCC Board of Directors, and our members from across 35 nations recognize the leadership you have demonstrated in driving competitiveness in Argentina. From large-scale enterprises to dynamic startups on the business scene, but all the things you contribute to in the social and economic life of your country. We recognize you for your building of new institutional partnerships needed to strengthen performance and improve competitiveness. We recognize you for your vision in creating a unique model in the establishment of the EXC organizations, promoting quality and excellence. And most importantly, at this time in your history of your country, we recognize you for your vision and leadership in driving institutional modernization as Argentina undertakes its historic journey of political and economic transformation. The GFCC, Santiago, applauds your manifold accomplishments. You inspire us all, and we are very honored to bestow the 2018 Global Competitiveness Award. So may I invite our colleague Adam Nadine up to the stage, whose company, Nadim Industries, has been very gracious to contribute the design and the creativity of this beautiful award we will bestow upon you. And then I'd like our chairman, Chad Holliday, to make a few remarks before we turn it over to you, Santiago.
Thank you very much. The award, the physical award, is right over there in case it's been overshadowed by the flamenco. The Global Competitiveness Award presented by the Global Council for Competitiveness has been designed as a golden globe being carried by seven arms, representing members reaching out to claim the seven continents where the Global Council members perform their activities. As much as the arms compete over the globe, it is they who hold and protect it in place. To sustain this, the arms unite, forming a single unified beam that enters into the box. As any beam of light is expected to travel straight through, it is only that special part of light that bends around the corner and sheds light on an otherwise dark area by bending out of the ordinary. It is this adventurous bit of light that we celebrate for its leading where the rest had not been. As a reminder of our ability to compete against all odds and fighting with the elements of our globe, this all sits on an olive wood base from an aging tree that competed with the harsh elements, starting from putting together air and water in the harsh desert of a hidden oasis. Though driven by competitiveness, we must not forget that even an olive tree, starting with nothing, can live on peacefully, spreading its fruit for millennia, yet in harmony with its globe. This award recognizes sustainable competitiveness. Though of nominal monetary value, this award only becomes significant when awarded to the worthy. Thank you very much.
Santiago, you set the example for us all to follow. This award is the most magnificent thing I've ever seen. Thank you so much. But it represents the breadth you brought to bringing the world together, 17 countries here this week, to make a difference. And we're just so delighted to have you in our Hall of Fame from the Council on Competitiveness. Congratulations. Thank you.
I have to be honest with you. Of course, I knew this would happen because we were together with a lot of people trying to scan the real guys who deserve to get this award from Argentina. And many names came to the table, like the Minister Ibarra, like Jorge Aguado, who is right here in front of us, right? And we started thinking, and we were like trying to understand who would really deserve this award. And someday, I remember it was a rainy day, and then Deborah called me with all the team, and they told me, you deserve this award. And my immediate reaction was, I mean, no, you're kidding me. I mean, this is not me. I mean, I'm part of a whole team. I don't deserve it. And we hang up, right? In a polite way, yes, but I say, no, no way, Jose. This is not possible. So the following day, Roberto Alvarez called me back, and he said, you really have to get this. Right, Roberto? And I said, I see no point in getting this award, which I was not really looking for. And you told me, but this award is important for the foundation, right? And then I realized, like, the foundation, Excelencia, is a group of a lot of hardworking people, volunteers, that are really making a difference on a very small scale, from our side, from our perspective. Right? So Roberto convinced me that I should take this award in the name of all the volunteers who have been working very hard to make a little difference in this country. So I would copycat what Chad did this morning, and I would ask all the volunteers from Excelencia to stand up, please do so. Because this award is for you. Come on, all of you, all the guys from Madrid, don't be shy. The Inti guys, Inti, where are you? Leo Spina, come on. If you are Argentinian, you have been working for the foundation. Jorge Aguado, you are a judge of the national. You're more worthy of this than me. This applause is for you. I mean, I don't deserve this. You guys deserve it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You don't know. This is yours. So really, I feel like the Oscar having here, and I'm supposed to have a long list. And I was sharing with my wife, Mercedes, like, if I have to really thank all the guys who made this possible, this would be extremely boring. And all the tango magic would be gone in 5 minutes. But the one thing I would really thank you for all the excellence members is all the support we got from you. We know we are just a little part of the innovation ecosystem. In Argentina, President Macri and all his team is making a difference, and they are fighting against a model who is extremely difficult to understand, because for the last 70 years, Argentina has been like squandering all his wealth. So hopefully we really can make a difference and move to a new direction. But again, we are just, in Excelencia, a very small part of the innovation ecosystem. So I'm very glad we got this. It's kind of a really nice reward for all the efforts we have put together. So thank you so much for that. And again, an applause for all the volunteers from Excelencia. When we started, and this was 4 years ago, we decided like our KPI, our metric, would be the hours of volunteers that are committed to the foundation. And at that time, the baseline was 2,400 hours. We are aiming to make that 10 times bigger this year. We think we would be getting to the 20,000 hours of volunteer work. I am very proud. And again, this is like our most important strategic metric of all. I mean, this is about ecosystems, and we are in the process of building a great ecosystem. I'm very proud. I'm very happy about that. And on a final word, you're right, Deborah. In 2011, on my money, I took a ticket to Porto Alegre. It's not that expensive, Porto Alegre, but it was out of my wallet, right? And I get to know a fantastic group of people, open-minded, with high intellect, right? Very talented people from the GFCC. It resulted to be just a foundational year, right? It was your second year. And eventually I follow you up on Dubai, and I get to know Deborah, Char, the rest of the team, and Roberto. At that time, we were like partners with Roberto, right? He was part of the Brazilian crew. And eventually, at some point, I discovered you became the executive director of GFCC. And we started working together. And I don't know, this is magic. We ended up here. Like at this night, this very same moment, I am so proud about this. I really thank you guys for this opportunity. Thank you so much.